In this video, I am going to cover arithmetic progression problem which will be given for O-level examination paper. For that I have selected 2019 past paper, and in that paper arithmetic progression question was given as question number 7. And this is the question. Sunita, who hopes to participate in a sports event, trains by jogging daily. She spends 105 minutes in the first week and 119 minutes in the second week for this. The time she spends training each week when taken consecutively lie in an arithmetic progression. So, in this problem, we will state a sequence of numbers with a certain story. In this year 2019, they have taken the training of Sunita, say first week of her training she spends 105 minutes by jogging. In the second week she spends 119 minutes. So when we take this consecutively, this builds an arithmetic progression. So what is the next or the third week time? The difference between second term and first term is 14. So to obtain the third term, we have to add 14 minutes to this value. 14 plus 119 is 133 minutes. We can continue like that. Under Roman number 1, they are asking the common difference of this progression. Common difference D is the difference between any two consecutive terms of this progression. We have to subtract second value from the pair we have selected. We have to subtract first value from the second value. 119 minus 105, which will give us 14, which is in minutes. Second question. 14 minutes, the time she spends training in the seventh week. Now they are referring to a value in this progression which is beyond our calculation. For that we have to apply the first formula of arithmetic progression, which is TN formula. TN formula, that is A plus N minus 1 times D, can be used to calculate any term of a progression. Since they are asking for the seventh term, we have to put T7. What is A? A is the first term of the progression. A is the first term of the progression, 105 plus N. N is the term we are finding. We are finding the seventh term. They are asking for the time, jogging time in the seventh week. That is seventh term of this progression. N is 7. 7 minus 1 into D. D is the common difference. Common difference is 14. That is plus 14. Since this is an increasing progression, we have to just substitute 14. Simplify this. This becomes 6 into 14. So we have 189. This is in minutes. That is the seventh term of this progression. As the third Roman number, they are asking, in which week does the time she spends training during a week first exceed 221 minutes? In which week does the time she spends training
during a week first exceed 221 means. That means we have to find the term which is more than 221. For that also we have to apply the same formula, TF formula. But in this problem, we have given the term as 221. We don't know whether 221 will be a term of this progression. It can be 221 or a time period, time more than 221. According to the problem, we have substitute 221 and find what will be it, because we want the term of the progression which is equal to 221 or more than 221. So we have to substitute TN, A, D and find N. First term is 105 plus N is what we want to find, D is plus 40. Take 105 percent. So 221 minus 105 is 117. 60. So this is, if we remove the bracket, it becomes 14 minus 40. Now take minus 14 here, it becomes 116 plus 14 is 130. Equals 14. To find n, we have to divide both sides by 14. So when I simplify this by 2, I get 7 and 65. Therefore, n is equivalent to a decimal 65 divided by 7. So it can be is approximately equal to 65 over 7 is 9.2 something. 9.2, approximately equal to 9.2. What is the meaning of this answer? This athlete will jog for 221 minutes or close to 221 minutes during 9th or 10th week. 9.2, that means in between 9 and 10, 9th week and 10th week. So the first time she will continue jogging for 221 minutes during 10th week, because we have 9.2. If it is 9th week, we can definitely say it is less than 221, because 221 will be reached after few days of 9th week. So it is 10th week. It is going to be 10th week. Answer is, she will first reach 221 minutes during 10th week. So this is the answer for Roman number 3. Roman number 4. Under part A, find the total time she spends jogging during the first 10 weeks of training. Now, in that question, there is a phrase total time. Total or sum is, so we had the progression, that is 105, 104, 119, 133. Likewise, so sum of three terms can be obtained from this formula, which is called SN formula. N by 2 into 2A plus N minus 1 into B. From TN formula, we can obtain any term of the progression. From SN formula, we can obtain sum of terms. So here they are referring to total time. So it is sum of time periods of this progression. So they want us to find the sum of times jogged for 10 weeks.
So we have to apply the formula first.
N is 10 because they are asking for 10 weeks. 2 into A. A is the first term. First term of the progression. Thus, N is again 10. Into D. D is the common difference which was found in Roman 1, 40. When we simplify, we have here 210 plus 10 minus 1, 9. 9 into 14. 9 into 14 is 116.
126. 5 into 210 plus 126 is
336. This is the total time she jogged for 10 weeks. This is also in weeks. This is the answer for the part A, question number 4. Now part B, if the average speed at which she jogs is 6 km per hour. Now the speed is given as 6 km per hour. Find the total distance she jogs during that time. For this one, we have to apply the speed formula. Speed equals distance divided by time. Speed is given. Time we know because they are referring for the 10th week value. During that time, that means during 10 weeks, so that is the time period. So we have to find distance, so subject B, that is speed into time. Speed is 6 kilometers per hour into 1680. This is in meters. Since speed is in kilometers per hour, we have to convert this minute value into hours. First, we can convert minutes into hours by dividing this by 6. 0, 0 get cancelled. 6 times 1, 6 times 1. So the distance covered will be 168. Since the speed was substituted in kilometers per hour, our unit is kilometers. So you will be given this kind of a progression problem in 2020 O-level question paper as well. We have only two equations, Tn equation and Sn equation. We can use Tn equation to find any term of a progression, Sn equation to find the sum of terms of the progression. First, read that introduction given in the problem and identify 3-4 terms of the progression. From that, you can do the question.